Imagine, billions of years ago, a universe that was vastly different from the one we know today. Back then, everything was compressed into an incredibly small and incredibly dense ball, no larger than the head of a pin. But this tiny point contained all the matter and energy that would eventually make up the entire universe. This was the universe before the Big Bang. And then, in a single moment, that tiny point exploded. The energy released in that explosion was so powerful that it created everything we know today. The universe started expanding at a rapid pace, and it's still expanding to this day. But where did this explosion come from? What caused the Big Bang? This is one of the biggest mysteries in all of science. One theory is that the universe was always expanding, and eventually, it reached a critical point where it couldn't hold itself together anymore. At that point, the entire universe collapsed in on itself, causing the explosion that we now know as the Big Bang. Another theory is that there was something called inflation that caused the universe to expand rapidly in the first moments after the Big Bang. This theory helps to explain why the universe is so uniform in temperature and composition. Despite the many theories, scientists still don't know for sure what caused the Big Bang. But what they do know is that it was a momentous event that created everything we know and love today. The stars, the planets, the galaxies, the you, the me, all of it began with the Big Bang. Or did it? We begin, as always, at the edge of the universe. The James Webb Space Telescope has been in the news since it was launched on Christmas Day, 2021. The Superstar Telescope has since unfolded the universe in a way no one expected. Because it looks so deep into space, the James Webb Space Telescope is also looking way back in time. Only recently it discovered six galaxies that existed only 500 million years after the Big Bang. Not just that, these galaxies are well formed and contain more stars than today's galaxies like our Milky Way. These galaxies should not exist as it toys with our model of cosmology. To make matters more uncomfortable for scientists, researchers from the University of Minnesota have discovered that one of these galaxies is so bizarre that we might have to go back to the drawing board. The James Webb Telescope can collect about 10 times as much light as the Hubble Space Telescope and is much more sensitive at redder, longer wavelengths in the infrared spectrum. This allows scientists to access an entirely new window of data of the early universe. However, in order to comprehend the early cosmos, we must travel back in time, to the point where time and space no longer existed. According to the theory of cosmic inflation, the universe was born with the Big Bang as an unimaginably hot, dense point. When the universe was just a hundredth of a billionth of a trillionth of a trillionth of a second in age, it experienced an incredible burst of expansion known as inflation, in which space itself expanded faster than the speed of light. During this time, the cosmos doubled in size at least 90 times. Rapidly expanding from subatomic to golf ball size. After that, the growth of the universe continued, but at a slower rate. As space expanded, the universe cooled and matter formed. Only 1 second after the Big Bang, the universe was filled with neutrons, protons, electrons, anti-electrons, photons and neutrinos. The light elements were created during the first 3 minutes of the cosmos, a process known as Big Bang nuclear synthesis. But for the first 380,000 years or so, the universe was essentially too hot for light to shine. 380,000 years after, however, matter began cool, and it cooled enough for atoms to form. However, after this point, the universe was plunged into darkness, since no stars or any other bright objects had formed yet. First forward to 400 million years after the Big Bang, and we can see the universe began to come out of its dark ages. This period in the universe evolution is called the Age of Reionization. The first stars appeared during this period, which lasted more than 500 million years. So galaxies, scientists thought, began building up in the first billion years after the Big Bang, and sort of reached adolescence at 1 to 2 billion years. However, the James Webb Space Telescope has found not one, but 6 galaxies that were fully formed only 500 million years after the Big Bang. And that is a problem. Using first-of-their-kind observations from the James Webb Space Telescope, a University of Minnesota Twin Cities led team looked more than 13 billion years into the past to discover a unique, minuscule galaxy that generated new stars at an extremely high rate for its size. The galaxy is one of the smallest ever discovered at this distance and could help astronomers learn more about galaxies that were present shortly after the universe came into existence. The volume of the galaxy is roughly 1/1,000,000th that of the Milky Way, but we can see that it continues to create the same amount of stars each year. The galaxies that existed when the universe was in its infancy are very different from what we see in the nearby universe now, explained scientists. Studying these galaxies could help us figure out how and when these first stars and galaxies emerged from within the universe's dark ages. Until then, it remains a mystery still as to how the universe came into being. As days pass, more results of observations from JWST is revealing that the universe, especially at its early stage, was stranger than we imagine. Webb has not only identified these early galaxies, but it has also detected a black hole that is nearly as old as the universe. Scientists have discovered what they believe to be the oldest known black hole in the universe, owing to the telescope's ultra-powerful sensors that captured this elusive entity. This supermassive black hole, which dwarfs our Sun by a staggering 10 million times, existed at the center of a galaxy 570 million years after the universe's inception, a time so remote it's difficult to fathom. To put it in perspective, the universe itself is estimated to be 13.7 billion years old. Observations collected through the James Webb Space Telescope have revealed an active supermassive black hole 10 million times the mass of the Sun, one that is actively growing as it slurps up matter from the space around it. At just 570 million years after the Big Bang, this is the earliest growing supermassive black hole detected yet, although scientists are hoping it won't remain the record holder for long. The black hole was found inside one of the earliest galaxies ever detected, previously known as EGSY8, though since renamed CERSTN19. Its discovery could help with one of the biggest head scratchers of the early universe: how the black holes in the cosmic dawn grew to such large size in such a short amount of time. We found the most distant active galactic nucleus, AGN, and the most distant, earliest black hole we've ever found, said an astrophysicist associated with the finding. Scientists were initially looking at CERSTN19 as part of their work investigating light produced by star formation in the very early universe. This light, called Lyman alpha emission, is thought to be generated by the ionization of neutral hydrogen by star formation activity. The early universe was filled with a fog of neutral hydrogen, which prevented light from propagating. It was only after this hydrogen was ionized that light could stream freely. This epoch of reionization, as it is known, is not fully understood. We know it took place in the first billion years after the Big Bang 13.8 billion years ago, but seeing that far into the early universe is really hard. CERSTN19 and a handful of other super early galaxies are excellent targets for this research, because they are relatively bright. The galaxy was identified in Hubble data in 2015, and at the time, was the earliest, most distant galaxy observed. Subsequent observations confirmed its existence, but more detailed information remained elusive. The earliest light in the universe has shifted so far into the infrared part of the spectrum due to the universe's expansion that a powerful, dedicated infrared instrument like JWST is necessary to probe them. So, when JWST came along, CERSTEN-19, the brightest of the Hubble galaxies from this epoch, was an obvious target. The telescope stared at the galaxy for just 1 hour, with all four of its instruments, but returned a wealth of data. In the moment I was kind of like, wow, look at everything we can see with JWST. We've seen this whole portion of the spectrum of this galaxy, and any galaxies early on in the universe, we've never seen before, said astrophysicist Rebecca Lawson. I was just overwhelmed by the amount of information. But then she noticed something she wasn't quite expecting. In addition to the light of star formation, there was a broad emission feature usually associated with AGN. And when she mentioned it to some AGN researchers, things started to get interesting. Typically, a galaxy in the early universe emits either light from an AGN or light from star formation. To see both in the same galaxy was extremely unexpected. There is some impact that the black hole is having on the emission lines that we are seeing, but most of the light we see in our images is still dominated by the star-forming part of the galaxy. That a supermassive black hole existed more than 13.2 billion years ago and was seen growing is not as surprising as you might think. Much larger black holes have been detected in the early universe. Scientists are still puzzled as to how the black holes in those galaxies became so enormous so early in the universe. What do you guys have to say? We have only recently discovered galaxies that formed only 300 million years after the Big Bang. These galaxies are big and complex, and scientists around the world were baffled, as according to the standard model of cosmology, such galaxies cannot exist so early on. Now, with the discovery of this black hole only some 500 million years after the birth of the universe, is a mystery in itself. The image of the early universe is changing faster than we expected. And, whether you like it or not, it's time to start over. So, would you like to travel to the other side of the universe, or stick with us here, at the edge of the universe? Until we meet again.